Okay, so now to give you a map of a cluster, think about it this way. This is all of us at IU connecting to this one big castle, which is your cluster, which has got lots of compute nodes. There is one login node that you're all accessing. So when all of us are doing SSH and logging in, this is the one node we're logging in. We're not using the compute nodes yet. And it's good to remember that all of us are using this login node, so it is a shared community space. And I'll explain why that's important, but essentially all the compute nodes, to submit any job to a compute node, you have to actually go in and actually type in another command, and I'll talk to you about that. But this is how it looks inside, if you think about it. Okay, so now once you log in the login node, you're given your own personal space. If you're moving into your new home, think about it in terms of your workspace or your desk right now. You have a home space, which is the computer or like the small limited space where you can put in files like your local software installations there. Files over here are never purged, which means system admins will not come in and look at what you're saving there. But it is limited space, so you should be mindful of that. Don't save everything there, especially if it's a lot of data files. And then you have your scratch space, which is your working space. This gets cleared every 60 days. Which are not active. So if you're not working on an active project or a directory that's not touched for 60 days, it'll go in and it'll get booked, so it gets deleted. And this is where it's you can store a lot of your big data sets, and this is where I download a whole bunch of my SRE files or like, you know, genome files over here, because it has that availability. And then you have your project space. This is when you're working with collaborators, like your entire lab together is working on this one data set. You can save it in your project space. You have to request this to the system admins. They'll set this up for you. It gets cleared only every 6 months, so it's more long. You can store things for longer time over there, and it's more collaborative space. You can request only 10 users to have access to this project space. And it's great even for inter-university, like if you want somebody else from another university to access that space, it's possible. And then you have your archive. So if you're not using something long-term, it's best to archive it because otherwise it gets purged. And so we have SDA, which is a pretty beautiful computer if you come to see. It's got a robotic arm that goes in and it's tape storage, which is, how do you explain it? So this is your workspace. So when you log in, you can set all of this up. You can see that all of them have different file paths. So you could go into these different file paths and you're essentially accessing all these spaces. Except for archive, which is in a separate computer, which you have to do, which you have to use a file transfer tool for it. To give you an idea of what it looks like on the back end, this is Carbonate cluster. So when you log in, you access the Carbonate cluster. The Carbonate cluster then accesses this other cluster, which is sitting somewhere else, that has got your home space. And then you have your scratch space, which is sitting in another cluster somewhere else. And then there's another cluster, which is your SDA, and they're all interconnected. So it's amazing how you can sit in one place and log in and access all this by just moving through different directories, but essentially they're all connected as different clusters in the data center. So when you go to the data center, they're not sitting right next to each other, they're actually different pods sitting in separate places. And then, so you have, so let's say now you start working with Carbonate and you store all your files in your scratch space, which is over here. And then you realize, wait a second, I don't want to run jobs on Carbonate, I want to run it on CAST. The good thing is CAST is also connected to your home space, to the scratch space, to Carbonate, and to the safe storage. So you don't have file transfer anymore. So you can work on any of these clusters in IU, and they're all in one place. You can just log into a different machine and all your files are saved in one place. They're all accessible. There's no file transfer at all. Another fun fact I like to hear about this is we spend millions of dollars on these high performance computing and they only last for 5 years, 6 years. And so this is like an ongoing problem. Like think about it as your mobile phone. Like after 5 years, your phone's, not even 5 years, I think 2 years, and your phone stops working on you. It's obsolete, right? And that's essentially what happens to these high performance computing clusters as well. So there's these huge pods with hardware that no longer work after 3-4 years because they're starting to like die out on you. And I'm pretty sure while we say we are the fastest AI machine, in like 2 months, somebody's going to beat us and say, no, we also have it and we're faster. So this is like an ongoing problem with having genomics data and computers. There's always something cooler out there. So Storage issues is one of the big concerns with biologists and physicists, and I think now it's starting to become other departments as well, but I'll focus a little more on biology because that's my background. If any of you have done a full-fledged genomics project or any biology projects, you'll notice that you'll start out with maybe a couple of gigs, and you'll end up generating about a terabyte of data. Right now, I'm working on a project where the input files are only about, I think, 30 gigs, and my scratch space is now filled with 1 terabyte of just scratch files, other downstream analysis, and this files and that files. And this just shows on. This just shows you to say storage is a big concern, and we're running out of this. Like, storage is becoming cheap, so we're not running out. But essentially, it is something to think about because when I'm backing this up on a hard drive, it's tons of hard drives that I need to save everything to, which is why SDA exists, where you can actually save a lot of it. So when you're moving files and you're saving them, or you're managing them and archiving them or sharing them, it becomes a problem. Because imagine sharing hundreds of terabytes of data with somebody else, a collaborator, or like sending this over to them, it's becoming a challenge. So think about this when you're doing your project space and everything. Look at the files you don't need and be mindful of that, because DC2, which is our scratch space right now, gets really full. There have been several instances where people can't even like CD in it, which is just typing the basic command to list anything that they have in their directory because it's so full. And the system admins are sending out emails saying, can you please delete your data, please? To overcome that, we do have a new scratch space set up. You have to request access to it, Slate. It is just a new project, and there will be more on this coming up. Just letting you know that if you think DC2 is acting up, you can move to Slate project space and work on it. But the difference is in DC2, anybody could save how much ever data. There was no space restriction on it. So it wasn't like a particular lab or a particular user had only this much space. Anybody could just drop in. Like somebody could be using 1 petabyte of data and somebody else using only 100 MB. But on Slate, it's the other way. You're actually space limited. So every user gets access to a scratch space of only 1.6 terabytes. And this is to make users more mindful of how much space they're using. You can request more space, and all of that is out there online somewhere, and I can talk to you a little more about it, but we are moving towards Slate very soon. Not, I don't know yet when, but it's gonna happen. Okay, so now that we talked about all the spaces on the clusters and what is a cluster, any questions on that? So?